In our last video, we had a Mac LC on the bench, with capacitors that needed to be replaced, a hard drive that wasn't showing up, and a bunch of work to do. Here in part two, we're going to replace those capacitors, we're going to take a look at the hard drive, and we're going to see if this thing boots. I ordered some capacitors from Console 5, who have done a great job for me in the past, and what I got for this was actually a set of tantalum capacitors. These all match up to what was existing, except they are, you know, no longer the electrolytics. So we're going to be doing pretty much the same thing, except these are now our new replacements, which we'll map up on the board. Of course, where the line is your positive lead, and so we're just going to give this a go. I'm going to try to do this the same way that I've done other SMD capacitors. So I am going to tin one side and lay the first side down and then solder up the second side and then reflow the one that I had originally tinned. And we're going to see how that goes. I've staged each tantalum capacitor next to where they're going to go. So now I'm going to start doing the tinning of each side. So it looks like my camera died while I was actually doing the soldering. So the caps are done, and it's time for reassembly. So the tantalums went in just fine. It was a new experience for me, mostly because they were just slightly more finicky than I'm used to, but it was absolutely doable. So our board slides into place just like it did before. And since we're just going to be doing a power-up test, I'm not going to go nuts with reconnecting everything. But let's just do it without the drive, without the hard drive, and without the battery. Let's just see if we can get it to power up. To do that, we're going to need the power supply. And that just slots in. And just to see what our speakers are going to sound like before we actually blow this thing off, let's put back the fan and speaker assembly to the pads. And that should be enough to get us to boot up. So I'm going to pull in a power cable and our monitor cable. But I'm going to flip this slightly just to work with what we've got here. Monitor, power, we'll turn on our monitor here, we're going to do a keyboard too, just in case, I believe that's where ADB is, yep, and let's power on and see what happens. Do we get a chime? Well, excellent. We have power. We have a clean display. It's turned out better than I expected. Let's add a drive. We will need power to the drive. SCSI. So I'm hearing noises from it, but it's obviously not spinning, it's not seeking. Let's hear it one more time. So before starting this, I did a little Googling. And apparently these quantum SCSI drives get head stick. The head stick happens because the bumpers on either side of the head break down over time, create a stickiness that causes the head to not be able to move anymore. It's gummed up. Now, normally, I would say don't ever open your hard drive, but we don't really have anything to lose here, do we? So maybe let's try a little hard drive surgery, do a little something new, and see if we can bring this back to life so I don't have to go order a SCSI 2SD. So from what I gathered, to open this drive, we need these six screws, and then there will be screws under here, and then under here. So let's start with the outside. Definitely some thread locker on these screws. This one looks like it was already busted into. So now, our warranty is void if the seal is broken, but I think we're past that, aren't we? And I think it's this one. And then there's this nut right here, and I don't know what this is in the middle, but from what I saw, the nut has to come out, and I don't have anything wide enough for just that nut, and the fact that it's recessed makes life difficult. So I'm going to do something stupid, and I am going to use pliers. And we'll see how that goes before we move on to something else. And that's actually shockingly easy once you use that pliers. So I guess that was the winning combination. Now the cover should come off, and the cover is going to be under. Probably sealed a little bit. So we're gonna very gingerly pop this using a flathead screwdriver. Now again, I don't care about any data on here because this wasn't mine, so whoever it was, if it's gone, it's gone. And also, as a forewarning, hard drives are very susceptible to dust. Obviously, this is old, 40 megabytes. The data density is far different than the multiple terabyte drives that we have today. You still don't want to have dust in there, so we want to keep it to a minimum. Let's see if there's anything kind of connected to the top here. No. Oof. That looks kind of brutal. You can see on the camera, this, I don't know, I've never seen a hard drive look like this, but it's kind of like build up here. This head is probably difficult to move. This is the piece that's going to come off because the bumpers are under here, and I'm not sure yet what I'm going to cover them with, if it's going to be like captain tape or masking tape. But let's, just for grins, let's boot this and let's watch the head move. So you can see it's just kind of frozen. It does not want to go anywhere. Look at that. You bump it just a little bit. Ooh, a sad Mac. Oh, what did we make mad? Well, that was something. I haven't heard the Sad Mac chime in a long time. Let's see if it'll spin again. Okay, well, we have a moving head, so that's good. We're not completely gone. And funny story, this thing's booting. So it is a working hard drive. So let's do some surgery. And let's not let this do this any longer than it needs to. So to take this piece off, Phillips. I'd imagine these are just as thread locked as the other ones. So we're just gonna do this gingerly. Okay, that comes loose. Ginger. That comes loose. I'll finish pulling these out now. As a note, the screws that were in the outside of the drive, all six Phillips were the same size. They look to be the same on the inside too. I'm keeping them in order just in case. And then let's pull this thing off. It's a magnet. It feels like a magnet. It is a magnet. So we have a bumper here. And then inside the mechanism here, we've got a bumper here. So these are the things that I'm going to cover up. So I can't figure out a way to actually pull this out. So I'm going to slip a little tape on there. And I'm going to hope for the best, because that's kind of all I got. So now that does it back in place, I'm going to move the head back over here, get the stop bar back here, put that in place over the head, and then we can put this piece back on. Just to show this terrible job that's been done, Use the tape along here. Use the tape along down here. Stop bar is in place. Head still here. So, I'm putting this back in place. Sorry about my hands. Been working on a bicycle. Woo! Oh my goodness. There it is. Put our screws back in place. Make sure this is positioned. We'll tighten it down. And then we'll put the cover back on. That on lightly. We'll put this Torx bit back. Make sure it's straight. Right. Our warranty is void. Good.
By Joe, we have a hard drive.
Ooh, system 6. 607. I think this thing was bought and never updated again. But look at that in all of its glory. Ooh, pyro. I haven't seen pyro in a while. Pyro was a great screensaver, particularly if you didn't want to buy After Dark. Excellent. Fantastic. I am suddenly in middle school again. Excellent. On the drive, we have somebody's fantastic selection of stuff here. Sorry about the refresh rate. It looks like we have MacWrite 2, FileMaker Pro, HyperCard, Games. What do we got here? Well, we have an obvious answer here. For some reason, I remember music. Maybe not on this one. Let's see, is it the arrows? Nope. Is it the number pad? Yep. Look at that. Wow, I'm gonna be doing this the rest of the day. Okay, maybe we should move on. This is faster than I remember it to be. Maybe because it's system 6. Well, I think from here, Maybe popping in some RAM and updating the System 7. Let's shut her down. Then we just had to fix this monitor situation. So, got some tape here. And here. Cut it to size, and then we'll just add our feet here. So one, and there's our other one. So with that, we have a working machine. A little slow at first. Caches are still warming up. That's it. 10 megs of RAM. Not upgraded VRAM, but the hard drive works. The output works. The sound works. It's running System 7.1. This is a pretty solid Macintosh LC. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. I think what I'd like to do from here, probably still end up replacing the hard drive. I'd like to upgrade the VRAM, but we're going to have to see on that one. Probably going to load this thing up with Oregon Trail and take it from there. But I guess with that, we'll see you next time.